imposing Western cultural ideas on other cultures, and I'm saying my culture is superior to your culture, and who am I to say it's better? And my response is really to look over time at the spread of certain ideals about freedom, about opportunity. My great-great-grandfather, I think it was when serfs were freed in 1848 in Eastern Europe, set out, and it's the end of the world. I think it's great that there was international pressure on what was then Austria-Hungary to free serfs. When it worked quite well, but Cheryl's asked that question, comes up periodically, because Cheryl's, her grandmother speaks Ravana. And, thank goodness there was Western pressure on China and foot bombing. Now everybody appreciates that as that's an important step forward. And so I think we need to be respectful of cultures, faiths, but that there are also certain boundaries where we have to weigh that against our respect for freedom, autonomy, equality, and in some cases those plans. So if somebody wants to burn a widow after the husband has died, the whole practice of seti, then that crosses a line. We should protest against that. Likewise, I would say the female genital mutilation, affecting 3 million girls each year in Africa alone, to me that crosses a line. And where those lines are and what practices, I think, is complicated. One can disagree about that. But I also think that it's a mistake to sit back and say, well, this is your country, go ahead and do whatever you want. Our compassion, our empathy should not depend upon the other person's passport color. I think we have common bonds of humanity that should lead us to speak up. But the other part of the question is kind of, even if I think we have a moral right to speak up and try it again, some of these practices, I also think that we have to be more clever about it. And for example, female genital mutilation is something that since the 1970s, there's been a major Western effort to end. There have been UN conferences held, there have been UN resolutions passed, there's been pressure put on country after country to change laws, so that much of the, and then in Sudan, for example, under British control, passed a law banning FGM, I think back in 1926 or something. And all of this outside pressure really accomplished next to nothing. One time I was in Somalia, and I saw a banner across the road in English about banning FGM. Like, no, let's not mutilate our daughters in English, in Somalia.